Welcome back. In today's video, I'll be showing you how to print screen or take a screenshot on your Mac or MacBook. There are different ways to take a screenshot, and we'll cover them in this video. You can choose a specific area to screenshot depending on the exact area you want to capture, and there is one simple method, and that's where we'll start. Remember to leave a like and feel free to subscribe if the video helps. Let's get into the method. The first and simplest way to take a screenshot is to use the first of the three keyboard shortcuts we'll cover. The keys to press are Shift, Command, and the number 3 key at the same time. This will take a screenshot of your entire screen and will likely save the image file to the desktop where you can store it or transfer it to wherever you want. To select a specific area of the screen to screenshot, for example just some of the information on the page, this time use the keyboard shortcut of Shift, Command, and the number 4 key. After pressing these at the same time, you will notice your cursor change to a cross and it will display coordinates. Click in one corner of the area you want to screenshot and then hold this click and drag to the opposite corner. When you let go of the click, it will automatically create and save the screenshot, again on the desktop. If you decide you don't want to take a screenshot whilst you have the cursor up, use the Escape key to exit the screenshot tool. Finally, you can use the keyboard shortcut of Shift, Command, and the number 5 key to bring up the screenshot and recording window. In here, you can see that there are all of the possible ways to capture and record your screen, so feel free to have a play around with each of the options. And so that is how to print screen or take a screenshot on your Mac or MacBook, including in a specific area of the screen. Click the card on screen now to watch a video of mine, showing you 10 easy ways you can speed up your macOS device. Help support the channel by visiting the store, the link is in the description and at the end of the video. If you have any questions, then let me know in the comments below, and if you did find today's video helpful, remember to leave a like, and feel free to subscribe for more tips in the future. Be sure to stick around to see some of my other videos that you might be interested in. Thanks so much for watching, and I will see you in another video.